In this video, I will talk about how to solve the job shop scheduling problem using the branch and bound method. The job shop scheduling problem is described as follows. There are a total of n jobs that must be processed on a single machine. The duration and the due date of each job are known. We need to decide the sequence of the jobs to minimize the total delay of all the jobs. The job shop scheduling problem is a typical combinatorial optimization problem, which is defined as an optimization problem with a finite number of feasible solutions. For example, we are trying to process n parts with a CNC machine. We will feed the parts into the machine in this direction. We can put any of the n parts in the first position. That means we have n options for this position. We can put any of the n-1 remaining parts in the second position. That means we have n-1 options for the second position. Continuing in this way, we have only one remaining part for the last position. Therefore, there are a total of n factorial feasible solutions for the job shop scheduling problem, which is a finite number. Now let's check this example. Three jobs, A, B, C, must be processed on a single machine. The time required to process jobs A, B, and C are 6 days, 4 days, and 5 days, respectively. The due dates of jobs A, B, and C are on day 8, day 4, and day 12, respectively. Suppose we will process the jobs in this order, A, B, and C. The duration of job A is 6 days, so it will be completed on day 6. The due date of job A is day 8, so the delay of the first job, job A, is D1 is equal to 6 minus 8 is equal to negative 2, which means the job is completed ahead of time, so the delay is 0. Then we start to process job B. The duration of job B is 4 days. So it would be completed on 6 plus 4, which is day 10. The due date of job B is day 4. So the delay of the second job, job B, is D2 is equal to 10 minus 4 is equal to 6, which means the job is delayed for 6 days. After that, we start to process job C. The duration of job C is 5 days. So it would be completed on 6 plus 4 plus 5, which is day 15. The due date of job C is day 12. So the delay of the third job, job C, is D3 is equal to 15 minus 12 is equal to 3, which means the job is delayed for 3 days. The total delay of this sequence is T is equal to D1 plus D2 plus D3 is equal to 9 days. This is just one feasible sequence. We need to find the best sequence to process the jobs so that the total delay of the three jobs is the smallest. We can solve this problem using the branch and bound method. First, let's define the decision variables. Xij is equal to 1 if job j is put in the ith position. Xij is equal to 0 otherwise. I denotes the positions 1, 2, and 3. J denotes the jobs A, B, and C. At the beginning, we don't know which job should be put in which position. We don't know the delay of any job. We don't know the total delay either. Now let's start with the last position, position 3. We can put job A here. We can also put job B or job C here. There are 3 options. For this option, we know that no matter what orders are for the first 2 positions, job A will always be completed on day 15, which is the sum of the durations of all 3 jobs, 6 plus 4 plus 5. Job A is due on day 8, so the delay will be 15 minus 8 is equal to 7 days. So D3 is equal to 7 days. The total delay is D1 plus D2 plus D3, so it must be greater than or equal to 7 days. Similarly, for this option, we we can get D3 is equal to 11 days, and the total delay must be greater than or equal to 11 days. For this option, D3 is equal to 3 days, and the total delay must be greater than or equal to 3 days. Next, we will follow this branch and check the second position because the total delay is smaller and it is highly possible to get a better solution compared to the other two branches. There is no guarantee though. We can put either job A or job B in the second position, so there are two options. For this option, we know that the total length of processing these three jobs will be 6 plus 4 plus 5, which is 15 days. Job C will need 5 days to process. So the completion time of job A is 15 minus 5, which is day 10. Job A is due on day 8. So the delay will be 10 minus 8 is equal to 2 days. So D2 is equal to 2 days. The total delay is D1 plus D2 plus D3. So it must be greater than or equal to 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 days. Similarly, for this option, we can get D2 is equal to 6 days, and the total delay must be greater than or equal to 6 plus 3 is equal to 9 days. We are not done yet. Next, we need to follow this branch and check the first position. We can only put job B in the first position, so there is only one option. For this option, we know that the total length of processing these three jobs will be 15 days. Job C will need 5 days to process, and job A will need 6 days to process. So the completion time of job B is 15 minus 5 minus 6 is equal to day 4. Job B is due on day 4, so the delay will be 4 minus 4 is equal to 0 days. So D1 is equal to 0 days. The total delay is D1 plus D2 plus D3, so it is equal to 5 days. Last, let's check other branches. We know that 5 days is less than 7 days, so this branch is fathomed. Similarly, the other two branches are also fathomed. This is the optimal solution. The best order is B, A, and C. The total delay is 5 days. Okay, that is how to solve the job shop scheduling problem. Thanks for watching.